is broken down by the fungi, mm-hmm. then there's a succession mm-hmm. of fungi. So the first ones are fungi that are living in the living wood. So when the tree is standing like that, there are plenty of fungi inside. They're not doing anything. They're not pathogens. They're not parasites. They're just living inside, mm. not doing anything. But then when the tree is down or the leaves are coming mm-hmm. down, then they change and they become, then they start to degrade. Mm. So their strategy is to be the first because there's so many here. So there are some that are starting there and that they're very good at that. Then the next ones that are coming in are the ones that are able to fight the first ones. Mm. And then you have a succession of fungi and the last ones are the ones that are very good at degrading very complicated substances, because the last thing that is left, now this is a young one, but if you have a very old one, then there are only the very difficult structures, chemical structures left in the wood, mm-hmm. and they're very good at that. But the first ones, it's these ones, these guys, that are, it's mold, like penicillium, mm-hmm. or things like that, the fusarium. This is probably a trichoderma, if you know trichoderma, mm-hmm. yeah, verticillium. They are fast growing and they are producing all kinds of substances mm-hmm. to fight the other fungi. Mm-hmm. So they are some of the interesting things. Whereas these ones that are coming here, yeah, mm-hmm. they are probably coming because they were the first ones. Mm-hmm. They were in the wood when it was alive. Mm-hmm. And now they're spoiling, mm-hmm. because they're, now they're gone. Mm-hmm. So they're not necessarily present in there. As these ones are taking over now. Mm-hmm. And then in a later stage you have another one. So these are also interesting. Mm-hmm. So if you want to isolate the... But then you have to grow, because then you have to pick it out and then you have to grow it in the lab. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hmm?
And you have, how many do you have? You see here you have this one, you have the yellow one, you have the grey one.
Yes,
yeah.
Nicholas, do you have a pen knife?
And you can and you can also see that they are actually fighting each other. Okay.
So yeah, was that what you're looking for?
Pinknife.
Oh, pinknife.
Yeah, it's
just for a second.
Okay, guys. Mm-hmm. This is so this is the final stage mm-hmm. where the wood is decomposed. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the wood is composed of cellulose, which is glycose in BJ1-4, okay, and then lignin that are phenols and various alcohols in these oxygen binders. Okay, and the phenols, they're toxic. That's why the cellulose is protected by lignin. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's covered by lignin. So with the fungi, they can do two things. They can either go in and take all the cellulose, this is the white stuff, and then leave the lignin. But then they can't take that much. Okay, or they can go in and remove the lignin and then take the cellulose. So what these guys are doing, the reason that it's white is because all the lignin has gone. So it has gone in and then it has released compounds, oxidases that are removing the lignin, and then so it can take up the cellulose. So the cellulose is left, and that's why it's soft now. Mm-hmm. And what does it do with the lignin afterwards? It's releasing the lignin mm-hmm. between, in this case, the fungus has gone in this way. Mm-hmm. So the different individuals are growing this way, and then between them, mm-hmm. it's releasing the lignin in these polymers, the black polymers. That's the polyphenols that are released between them. So they are forming sort of tubings in the wood, mm-hmm. and so you have two different individuals on each side, and this black line here that is going through the wood is simply the polyphenols that are released. Into the, it's called melanin, mm-hmm. The black stuff here. So it's all these oxygen bindings that have gone together and forming this. And when this is completely gone, then you'll see these black lines, they will still be here. Mm. If we find a trunk somewhere, we can still see them. And the reason that the soil often is dark is simply because of this. So it's old lichen. And it's toxic. When you can burn it, that's what you find in coal. That's old lichen from the old forest in the way back in time. That's nice, yeah. And then you have all the termites, yeah. The termites are falling, yeah. The interesting thing about insects and wood is that here you can clearly see that you have this, a fungus growing here, and then you have a demarcation line around it. Mm-hmm. So it's having a. Here you also have two different. Mm-hmm. One is very good at removing the lichen, and the other one is not. The interesting thing about the insects in the wood is that insects are not able to digest cellulose. Mm-hmm. So they cannot live from wood. You don't have any animals that can live off the cellulose. Mm-hmm. So if you have an animal that eats cellulose, like a cow, mm-hmm. it needs microorganisms mm-hmm. to degrade the cellulose. You know, the cow has the stomach. Yeah. The termites, they have a fungus or bacteria that can degrade the cellulose. Mm-hmm. The ants, they use, and even beetles that are crawling in the where the larva is living in the wood, mm-hmm. they're only living in the wood for protection. Mm-hmm. So they need to have a fungus with them. So the beetle has a fungus, mm-hmm. and then it inoculates the wood, and then it's crawling around in the wood and eating the fungus. So there's a symbiosis between the beetle and then insects, all insects and that are living in wood and fungi. Mm-hmm. Nice.